Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor of Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilpendi. I am happy to meet you again through the video lecture series on heat and mass transfer for the fifth semester mechanical engineering students. So this is module 5. We are going to discuss the radiation heat transfer. Lecture number 1 will discuss the radiation theories. So in the beginning, we discussed the three modes of heat transfer. In the three modes of heat transfer, we introduced the radiation heat transfer, which does not require a medium for heat transfer. That means the radiation heat transfer may occur even in vacuum. And we introduced the Stefan Boltzmann law. The body emits, any surface or body emits radiation that is measured from the Stefan Boltzmann law. And the learning outcome for this lecture, at the end of this lecture, the student will be able to define what is a black body and what is the solid angle, and the student will be able to explain the black body radiation intensity and black body emissive power, and also you will be able to discuss the Wein's displacement law. So we will take one by one. Just a recall the two diagrams. So here radiation is the mode of heat transfer which does not require a medium. But here the radiation occurs, so in the presence of the atmospheric air. Actually, the presence of the atmospheric air will diffuse the radiation. So the amount of heat radiated will decrease because of the atmospheric air. And we consider this diagram. We have an insulated chamber, vacuum chamber, and also it is insulated, completely insulated. And we have a hot object. So it is vacuum chamber, so there is no fluid inside. And the hot object, it is not physically making contact with the wall. So the hot object at higher temperature, the wall of the chamber is at lower temperature. So you leave it this object for a certain time. And you can put thermometer to measure the temperature of the wall and temperature of the object. And after some time, we find that the hot object and the wall of the chamber, they reach the thermal equilibrium condition. That means the temperature of the hot object and the vacuum chamber are equal. How this is possible? There is no physical contact. So the conduction heat transfer is not possible. There is no fluid between the hot object and the vacuum chamber wall. So the conduction heat transfer is also not possible. So the only mode of heat transfer possible is the radiation. So radiation, thermal radiation refers to the radiation energy emitted by bodies by virtue of their temperature. Any surface, any body, because of the temperature, it is emitting radiation. That is what the basic principle. And all bodies at a temperature above the absolute temperature emit thermal radiation. Any surface, any body, even the human body, it is radiating energy. Because of the temperature, body temperature, it is radiating energy. And radiation may occur even in vacuum. That is what we have seen here in the diagram. And radiation is a volumetric phenomenon. So the total surface, all the surfaces of the object, they are emitting the radiation. And look at the diagram. The earth surface, we are receiving the heat energy from the sun. It is only by the radiation. So the amount of heat energy received from the solar radiation to the earth surface, it is purely by radiation. And these are all the some of the thermal radiation images. There is one camera called thermal image camera. So using this thermal image camera, you can capture all the images. That indicates everything is emitting radiation. So the temperature image is shown there. They have different different color images. They are indicated by the scale at the side. So that indicates the temperature. Thermal image camera, so which is useful for many of the operations. And this example also we are familiar. So the thermos bottle, so which preserve the temperature of the liquid, the temperature of the object inside for 3 to 4 hours. It is because of the vacuum. So you look at thermos bottle. Thermos bottle minimizes the energy transfer due to conduction, convection, and radiation. The stopper is made by rubber or plastic to minimize the conduction. It is made by a material of lower thermal conductivity. And double-walled glass vessel with a space between the wall is evacuated to minimize energy loss due to the conduction and the convection. And the silvered surface reflect most of the radiation energy that would otherwise enter or leave to the liquid in the thermos. So the highly polished surface that will reflect the energy, so that will reduce the radiation heat transfer. So these actually this thermos bottle is actually we have provision to minimize all the three modes of heat transfer so that we can preserve, we can maintain the temperature of the fluid inside for a longer time. Radiation theories. The first theory, there are two theory we are going to discuss. One is the Maxwell's electromagnetic theory proposed by Maxwell in the year 1864. According to him, the energy is emitted in the form of electromagnetic waves. Thermal energy, heat energy is radiated in the form of electromagnetic waves. When you treat the heat transfer as electromagnetic wave, immediately frequency and the wavelength, they are coming into picture. So the frequency of the waves equal to speed of the light in the medium divided by wavelength of the electromagnetic wave. So nu, the frequency nu equal to c by lambda, where c is the speed of the light in the medium. Reference velocity is speed of the light in the vacuum, which is 2.998 in 10 power 8 meters per second. So the Maxwell theory, it treats as electromagnetic wave, which gives the nu equal to c by lambda. So this equation you have to remember. Another theory, Planck's quantum theory. So the Planck's quantum theory proposed by Planck in the year 1990, propagation of discrete packets of energy. Radiation is propagation of discrete packets of energy. The discrete packet, they are called as quanta. So the energy possessed by each quanta E equal to H into nu. The H value from the previous definition C by lambda. So H in nu value, the frequency is from the previous definition. So H into C by lambda. H is the Planck's constant, which is 6.625 in 10 power minus 34 joules second. So from the equation, you can observe one thing. Lambda is in the denominator. The wavelength is in the denominator. When the wavelength decreases, the energy will increase. That means the wavelength, waves with the shorter wavelength will have higher energy. So this you have to remember. The waves with the shorter wavelength will have higher energy. And this is the portion of spectrum of radiation. And you just look at the diagram. And the wavelength is given in the x-axis in micrometer. And it is from between 10 to the power minus 5 to 10 to the power 5. The wavelength, these are all the wavelength lower value. And these are all the wavelength of higher value micrometer. And here in the, what we are interested in, the thermal radiation, which is falling between 0.1 micrometer to 100 micrometer. So thermal radiation falls between 0.1 micrometer to the 100 micrometer. And in the thermal radiation, we have a small band of visible light, which is between 0.4 to 0.7 micrometer. And the lower wavelength, ultraviolet rays, X-rays, gamma rays, they are coming. The higher wavelength, microwaves. So these are all the interest of the radiology people. So the X-ray is penetrating the human body and taking the X-ray diagram. It is because of higher energy possessed by the X-ray. The X-ray waves, they can penetrate the human body because of the higher energy. And here it is microwave. It is interest of the electrical and electronics engineers. So we mechanical engineer, we focus here between 0.1 and 100 micrometer, which is called as thermal radiation. And we have the VibGR, wavelength of different color, VibGR, V, B, G, Y, O, R, violet, blue, green, yellow, orange, and red. For each color, there is a range of wavelength. Violet color, the range is 0.4 to 0.44 micrometer, blue color 0.44 to 0.49 micrometer, green color 0.49 to 0.54 micrometer, yellow 0.54 to 0.6 micrometer, orange 0.6 to 0.67 micrometer, and red 0.67 to 0.76 micrometer. So the range of the VibGR is 0.4 micrometer to 0.76 micrometer. So this is the, so we have the basic color, VibGR colors. So each color has got its own wavelength, that is what given here in the diagram. And we take the define the black body. So black body, it is a reference body for radiation, all radiation heat transfer calculations. So black body is an idealist body which absorbs all the incident radiation from all direction at all wavelength without reflecting and transmitting. Initially, we just understand black body is a reference body which absorbs all the incident radiation from all directions at all wavelength. And we define another parameter called spectral black body radiation intensity. What is the radiation intensity of a black body? Spectral means at a particular wavelength. If you look at the previous definition, black body from all direction at all wavelength. So a wavelength, it may vary from minus infinity to plus infinity. Or if you take the thermal radiation, it is between the 0.1 micrometer to 100 micrometer. So we restrict to thermal radiation, it is 0.1 micrometer to 0.100 micrometer. Now, in the range between 0.1 to 100, we discuss, and at a particular wavelength, for example, 0.1 micrometer, we have to calculate the radiation intensity. That is what spectral black body radiation intensity. So calculating the black body radiation intensity at a particular wavelength. So it is defined like this. The radiation energy emitted by a black body at an absolute temperature T streaming through unit area perpendicular to the direction of propagation per unit wavelength per unit solid angle about the direction of propagation of the beam. So the radiation is propagating from the surface at a particular temperature T per unit area per unit wavelength per unit solid angle. So per unit wavelength, per unit area, that you can understand. Per unit area means A is one unit, wavelength is per unit wavelength at a particular wavelength at 0.1 one micrometer, and unit solid angle. So here we have to understand the solid angle. So in the radiation, it is a volumetric phenomena. So we have to find out this solid angle. To understand this solid angle, I have an image. Look at the diagram. It is the hemisphere, half of the sphere, and we mark a surface, we mark a small area on the surface of the hemisphere, a rectangular surface. How this rectangular surface is obtained? We draw the two line circles and we draw the arc, right? So this area enclosed by the on the surface of the hemisphere is DA. It has got the four corner. All the four corners are connected to the center of the hemisphere. Now this angle inscribed by the all the four line, that is what called a solid angle, which is given by d omega. So the elemental solid angle d omega equal to dA, the area divided by r square. R is the distance between the surface and the center. So elemental area divided by the distance to the power 2, that is what the elemental solid angle. D omega equal to dA by r square. And the solid angle for the sphere, so you calculate the area of the sphere 4 pi r square divided by r square equal to 4 pi. And solid angle of the semisphere 2 pi r square by r square equal to 2 pi. So you can calculate the solid angle for any object knowing the definition d omega equal to dA by r square or omega equal to a by r square. A r is the distance between the surface and the center and dA is the area. Now the black body radiation intensity, it is given by the equation Ib lambda, which is equal to 2 hc square by lambda to the power 5 exponential of hc by lambda kt minus 1, where h is the Planck's constant and c is the speed of the light in the vacuum and the k is the Boltzmann constant and the t is the absolute temperature. So this equation is the basic equation which is also available in your data book. So you can easily pick up the equation, solve the problem. And spectral black body emissive power. So this previous one is spectral black body radiation intensity IB lambda. So intensity of radiation, black body intensity of radiation at a particular wavelength lambda. Now this is emissive power. So emissive power, E stands for emissive power, B stands for black body, lambda stands for a particular wavelength. So emissive power of a black body at a particular wavelength, that is what the spectral black body radiation emissive power, which is pi into IB lambda. So substituting from the previous equation IB lambda and simplifying, EB lambda equal to C1 divided by lambda to the power 5 exponential of C2 by lambda t minus 1, where here C1 and C2, they are constant. C1 equal to 3.742 in 10 power 8 watts micrometer to the power 4 by meter square and C2 equal to 1.4389 into 10 power 4 micrometer Kelvin. So this equation again available in the data book. You can pick up the equation and solve the problem. And we have this equation. This is what the equation we discussed earlier, EB lambda equal to C1 divided by lambda to the power 5 exponential of C2 by lambda t minus 1. On the right hand side, we have only two variables, lambda and t, and C1, C2, they are constants. Now the graph is drawn. So the x axis is micrometer, wavelength at micrometer, and y axis EB lambda, and the lines for different temperature. So you look at the curve. For example, 1000 Kelvin. The value at micrometer, I mean 8 micrometer, the emissive power is 10 power minus 6 and the emissive power is increasing with respect to the wavelength. As the wavelength increases, the emissive power increases, it takes a maximum value and then it decreases. This is what the trend for 100 Kelvin. So 100 Kelvin, emissive power increases, it takes a maximum value and then decreases. You take to the next value 300 Kelvin, the same trend is followed. So for all the temperature line, all the temperature, the line, the value of the EB lambda is increasing, takes a maximum value and then decreases for everything. So here again the 5800 Kelvin solar radiation, again it is increasing, takes the maximum value and then decreases. Now for every curve, there is a peak point. So you draw one line connecting all the peak points. So this is the locus of maximum power. So along the line, there is one equation, common equation, which is lambda t equal to 2897.8 micrometer Kelvin. So here along the line, this condition is satisfied. Lambda t maximum, that is equal to 2897.8 micrometer Kelvin. That is what Wein's displacement law. So why it is called as Wein's displacement law? The peak value is displaced, is moving towards the left side. The peak value, when you increase the temperature, the peak point is shifted towards the left side. So it is shifted, it is displaced towards the left side. That is why it is called as Wein's displacement law. The value is lambda max t equal to 2897.8 micrometer Kelvin. And this equation is also important for solving problems in the radiation heat transfer. And we have a reflection spot here. from the 15-20 minutes discussion, what are all the points we remember, we just see. Energy of electromagnetic waves is higher for shorter wavelength. So say yes or no. The answer is yes. Shorter the wavelength, the energy will be more. Radiation is a volumetric phenomena. This is also true. What is a black body? Black body is an idealized body which absorbs all the radiation heat transfer from all wavelength, from all direction, right, without transmitting and reflecting. That is what the black body. What is the importance of black body radiation heat transfer? So this is the idealized body which absorbs all the radiation heat transfer. So that is why we take the black body as a reference body for radiation heat transfer calculations. So these are all the reference books for the discussion. You can refer to the book for further knowledge on the topic. And this is the book what I have published earlier in the heat transfer. You can refer to it for more understanding of the subject. And you can write to me, to my mail ID for any clarification. I will answer to you sincerely. Thank you. We'll meet in the next lecture.